Hey everyone, welcome to Flutter Mentor's very first tutorial. So to start out, we're just going to go with explaining string interpolation in Dart, which is Flutter's official and only programming language. So this is going to be a very basic explanation because it's not an advanced topic or anything. Still, if you have any doubts, just drop a comment below and I'll get to it. Without any further ado, let's get this started. So string interpolation, for those who don't know, is when you want to make the text that is going to display dynamic, or you want to use a variable to define what text should be displayed. Obviously, if you just want to write something that's just, static, it'll never change, you can just write string interpolation, that's it. But even then, on Dart, there are a few specific rules for when you use special characters. And let's get to it right now with the special characters. Let's imagine that instead of text, we say Jane has $20. Okay, but with the symbol. Now, as you can see, this breaks everything. And let's see what the error says. Expected an identifier. Okay, if I were a complete newbie, I would probably have no idea what that would mean. So here's the explanation. The dollar sign is a special character in Dart. I will get to it in a bit, but for now, here's how to actually use it. You use a backslash, and that will always take care of special characters. If you put a backslash before a special character, Dart will always understand that it's not the special character that you want to use, it's the actual regular text character. If I save this right now, as you can see over here, Jane has $20. It's very simple. I'm going to make the text a little bit bigger, just in case it's too small for you guys. In case you don't know, you learned something new as well. It's pretty simple. You just text style, and then font size, and let's give it a big one, like 25. Okay. You could do that without the dot zero, but it takes a double. I like doing things like this. Maybe I'm a bit of a nerd for that, but it's just how I do it. But feel free to do however you prefer. Anyway, Jane has $20, that's wonderful. What if you want to say something that has an apostrophe? For example, Jane has a job that pays $20 an hour. That's amazing. And, it broke because of the quote, but maybe if we put another one here, still weird. Nope, still doesn't work. You know why, don't you? It's pretty obvious, right? The backslash is missing. The backslash is going to save you every time you have a problem with special characters. Do not worry about that. And if you save this, there it is. Jane has a job that pays $20 an hour. That's amazing. Now the sentence is a little bit too long. Let's shorten it. Jane earns $20 an hour, doesn't matter. It's a little bit too big, let's do it like this. Okay, there it is. And now, let's say you have a variable, let's just say you go and say final string, let's call it, foo, the classic, equals, let's say EA, because we're happy for Jane. Whatever. Okay, now if you want to use this variable here, you could opt for the old school Java way. You could just literally do this, like concatenate at the end, and this will work, but it's not how Dart wants you to go about it, It's not the convention that you should follow. Instead of this, you should just use the dollar sign, but without the backslash, If you use the dollar sign, then you can put in any variable that you want, and it works just the same as before, as you can see. Let me just put a little period here. Now, this is a really simple variable. Sometimes, you have a class, and you want to use an attribute of that class, much like this, So let's check that out now. I created a variable This time it's actually a var. I didn't even specify the kind. You can do this in Dart because it will just infer the type. In fact, if I press Control Q on Windows, it tells you right here, type text class, because this is the class that I created. Oops. No, now what we want to do is say yay here. And then let's delete this one. We don't need it anymore. We want to use this yay instead of the one we had before. But we can't just do this, because what do you think will be the outcome of this? It's pretty simple. It's an instance of text class, because this is a class, okay? Text class equals the class. So you need to access the title of a text class. So what happens if you do that? Let's try dot title. And what? That's kind of weird, huh? It treats this as regular text. What's missing? Very simple. Every time you append something to a variable, you have to wrap it in curly braces. Every time it's more than a simple variable, you just need to use the curly braces, no matter what. And now, if we save this, this will actually work. There it is. Jane earns $20 an hour. That's amazing. Yay. Everybody's happy. And hopefully you're happy too, because hopefully you've learned something new with me today. And if you did, please like and subscribe. You know, any help is appreciated right now. The channel has just been created. Hopefully we can do great things together in the future. And I hope I can teach many people out there how to use Flutter so that many more people can create their own apps and you don't have to spend $20,000 just to create a small idea that you have in your mind. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next lesson. This is Flutter Mentor and out.